because it makes it a lot easier to deliver those systems and services that we're all trying to deliver. To that end, I want you to know that we're looking for a space like that, and I know there are a number of different things that people are chasing at the moment. We have a critical need right now with regards to the homeless shelter, and a number of people, particularly Jena Gullo, by the way, is working tirelessly on that effort along with Commissioner Nancy Guy. And that's a short-term and a long-term opportunity that we have to face. But so let me ask you this question, and only by a show of hands, or if I only do this twice. If we had the perfect spot in our city, and it's likely Bismarck, by the way, one that gives the clients that need these services access in terms of walkability to all the services they need, whether on site for delivery of behavioral health, or if they have to walk to a clinic, walk to a hospital, have to walk from the jail or to the jail or to the courthouse, or have to walk to a grocery store, have to walk somewhere. If we could find that space, which means it's fairly close to downtown Bismarck, by a show of hands, would you all support the community effort to try to house as many of these services within one square block, by a show of hands, as being yes? Thank you. Now, one other question. Do you think we should, as a community, reconsider the plans currently underway to take the old jail and courthouse and maybe look at that as one of the options, by a show of hands? Thank you. Renee, this is all yours.
The United Way is even one person. We do not want one person freezing and dying out in the cold. To give you an example of some of the referrals, we had Mandan Police Department call me on a Friday night. They had a grandmother with a 15-year-old and 2-year-old grandchild. We will house them because they would have been out in the cold. We worked really closely with Mandan Public Schools to say, how is this 15-year-old going to get to school on Monday? Who is going to be contacting CPS, et cetera? Those are the types of situations. We also had a gentleman who has been off of his medications, antipsychotic and antidepressant, for 2 months. And he has a history of alcoholism. That is a crisis. It's a crisis for everybody. We're seeing so many different scenarios, and this is a really good opportunity to invite everyone in the community to be of help. When we're talking about staff size, we have 5 full-time employees at United Way that have other job duties. If you can help us answer phones, come to our office during the daytime, or help with intake, we will train you. I used to run a homeless program back in New York many moons ago. We will train you and equip you with what you need, but we do need more manpower until we can hire trained staff.
Assisted and relocated and have had choices of other housing and have made their own way into other locations. And we also assisted many of them in finding other locations in the apartments over there. But in 2016-17, our fiscal year, July 1 to June 30th, we over 730 people participated or were engaged in the transitional living program at Boulevard. Over 500 of those individuals were women and children. We now have full-time daycare. We have a licensed daycare on site. We have our after-school program with the MRBC. And so we're continuing to grow that program. First quarter 17-18, 261 people have been engaged in the transitional program of entering the program at Ruth Meiers and being provided the supportive services to move back out. Our objective is reintegration. And right before Thanksgiving, we integrated 25 people back to the community into apartments, reconnection with family or friends, or relocated out of Ruth Meiers. The program part of it, though, is please, we will work with any agency, we're working with multiple agencies, But it is an integration of services. We can't provide it all. The other part of it, it's an intake process that we go through. We have limitations on who can come into the program based on offenses and felons and other situations. We will provide an emergency need. If there's a need, we can take somebody into the program, but it does require an intake process. So we're there. Our projections this year, based on our first quarter, if we're looking at through 2017-18, right now we're looking at, in the transitional program, an estimation of 900 people coming into the program. And if the trends stay, it's still going to be about that two-thirds, one-third. Two-thirds women and children, families, and